Hey guys, how you doing? This is Jake Wyer with Blue Coast Real Estate, Wilmington, North Carolina. And I want to talk to you guys today a little bit about specific neighborhoods here in the Wilmington, North Carolina area. So I get this all the time from my clients. They want to have a three-bedroom, two-bathroom home in an established neighborhood, family-friendly, good school districts. You know, we're all kind of looking for the same thing. So what I'm going to go over today is six great neighborhoods in Wilmington. Now, when I speak of Wilmington, I'm talking about New Hanover County in general. So all these neighborhoods are going to be in New Hanover County, and I'll do some other videos going over great neighborhoods in Hampstead and also Leland and some of the other surrounding communities. But today we're going to focus in specifically on New Hanover County, which we're just going to go ahead and term as Wilmington, which is what most people do term New Hanover as. So without further ado, let's go ahead and talk about neighborhood number one. So neighborhood number one is North Chase. So we're going to start at the north end of Wilmington and work our way south. So North Chase, great, great neighborhood. It's actually in the Laney School District. And these homes, I'm going to go ahead and put up a couple of them up here that you can kind of take a look at. Built in the mid-90s, there is an HOA. Now with that HOA, you do get some amenities. So you get a pool, you get basketball courts, you get some picnic areas, some playground areas. So there are stuff for the kids to do. And then there's common area maintenance. So the whole area is actually very well maintained. And it's actually directly across the street from the high school. So this is going to be Laney High and Trask Middle School. So, and this actually does keep you outside of Wilmington city limits, which is actually pretty important for some people for tax purposes, for property tax purposes. You're going to pay a little bit less being only in the county, not in the city. So some of these are going to be in the county. Some of these are going to be in the city and county. So North Chase, that's our first one that we're going to talk about. So beautiful area, very young, family-friendly neighborhood, very safe, all the way to the north end of Wilmington. So if you're looking for a lot of bang for your buck, this is a great option for you with some amenities, kind of a low-key HOA situation. So number two for communities that I absolutely love in the area, Quail Woods. So Quail Woods actually is going to not be in an HOA, so you're not going to have any amenities. It's an established neighborhood. Late 80s, early 90s is when most of it was built. It's kind of eclectic. It's not going to be cookie cutter, so you're going to have a little bit of this and that. So the neighborhood does have that kind of feel to it. That's just not going to, every house is not built by the same builder. Some people like that. Some people don't. Again, very family-friendly neighborhood. This one actually is going to be going to those same school districts. So this is going to be, again, Trask and Laney. And like I said before, this is not an HOA, so you have no amenities. It is a little bit below, as far as geographically speaking, below North Chase. So it kind of keeps you in the northern end of Wilmington. But this one actually is also not in city limits. So property tax-wise, that's going to make a difference for some folks. All right, let's get into number three, amazing neighborhood, Bayshore Estates. This is actually one of my favorites, actually, under $350,000 neighborhoods. And the reason why I really like this neighborhood is it's got mature trees, lots of mature trees, wooded lots. You're going to get larger lots, so you're going to get into the half-acre lots in this area. And this one was built in, well, starting in the late 70s. There's some 80s and some 90s in there as well. So it's kind of an eclectic neighborhood as far as, you know, each house is not all by the same builder. So you're going to get some different variation as far as the streetscape is concerned. And some people really do like that. Again, there is no HOA in this neighborhood either. It does have an extra bonus that you can pay a little bit extra. And there is a boat ramp actually in this neighborhood that you can use. School districts, it's actually in one of the top elementary schools. So this is an Ogden Elementary School District. So it does still go to the Laney High School, but Ogden Elementary is a great choice as far as elementary schools, and Noble Middle School. So again, one of my favorite under 350 neighborhoods. A lot of people really love this area. So keep it on your list if you're looking for family-friendly areas that kind of has an interesting, unique streetscape. Lots of big mature trees. So next, we're going to go head on down south. So this one's going to be a lot more central, kind of closer to the historical downtown side of things. It's what's called Midtown area. So Carriage Hills neighborhood is a great option as well if you want to stay kind of more central, not to the far north or south. So you're going to stay kind of in the middle, so you're close to kind of everything, including the historical downtown, which is important to some. Now, this does put you within Wilmington city limits, so you're going to be dealing with New Hanover County property taxes as well as Wilmington city taxes. So you're going to be paying about 70% more, give or take, to live within the city limits for property taxes, as opposed to just living in the county. Basically built in the mid-90s, is right next to one of the brand new shopping centers, The Point. So it has a movie theater there, restaurants, things of that sort, brand new. They're still building it out, actually, as of today, which is we're in October 2020. So keep that in mind as well. You're going to be getting about quarter acre lots in this neighborhood. It does have really good canopy as far as mature landscaping goes. So that's a bonus for a lot of folks too. Moving forward, let's talk about Renwick. So this puts us over in the Masonboro Loop area. So this is actually one of my favorite places to bring clients, is the Masonboro Loop in general and Greenville Loop area. Very scenic, has the big overhanging live oaks with the Spanish moss, feels very southern, feels very coastal. It's right on the intercoastal. So built in the late 90s, it is within the city limits. So most of Masonboro Loop is going to be in the city limits. So again, you're going to be paying those city taxes. The schools are going to be Bellamy, Myrtle Grove, and Ashley. And the thing I really like about this whole area and Brenwick specifically is the fact that it's very central and on the coast. So very easy to get to downtown, about 15, 20 minutes to the historical downtown. Very easy to get to shopping, like the Mayfair Shopping Center. It's also about 15 minutes. To get to Wrightsville Beach, again, 15 minutes. So it gives you a lot of options as far as kind of keeping you very central up and down on the coast. And I say this lot, the north-south orientation, just because Wilmington does lay out in that way. So if you're very far to the south and very far to the north, most of your shopping and things like that will stay in those areas. Now, if you're in the middle, you're going to be a little bit more willing to go kind of all over the place and use a little bit more of the other facilities. See folks in other parts of town. People start getting a little bit lazy in Wilmington as far as visiting people outside of a half hour radius, I found. So now we're going to go far south, all the way to the far south. This is going to put us in the Monkey Junction area. It's what people call the Monkey Junction area, the far south part, right before you hit Carolina Beach. And this is going to be the Century Oaks neighborhood. Now, again, this is one of our favorite southern Monkey Junction neighborhoods. Established, very established, built in the early 2000s. A lot of ranch style with that frog above the garage. Very family friendly. The thing that we love about this neighborhood is bang for your buck, of course, because it's under 350. But also, you're outside of city limits, so only county taxes. Very nice, mature landscaping, very family friendly. There's lots of young families in this area, but you're also right there next to Carolina Beach. So if you're looking for that coastal experience, this puts you, I would say, within 10 minutes of Carolina Beach and Curry Beach. So it puts you right there. So it does feel very beachy on that side of things. And you're right there next to the Cape Fear River, if you like to use the river. So Century Oaks is another great, great option, one of our favorites as well, all the way down to the southern end of Wilmington. And like I said, that does put you outside of city limits. And your schools on that one are going to be, let me see, your schools on that will be Bellamy, Myrtle Grove, and Ashley. And the cool thing about those schools is they actually all lay out on the same street. They're all right next to each other and kind of newer campuses. So if you have kids in multiple grades, you know, ranging from elementary up to high school, might save you a little bit of trips here and there to have them all right next to each other as easy drop-offs. So I hope this is helpful. These are all homes under 350. So very affordable, all of them very family-friendly. And some of them are in HOAs, some of them are in city limits, so you know, you got to decide what's important to you. But the next videos I'm going to do are going to be Hampstead and Leland under 350 as well. And then I'm going to try to touch on some stuff that's 450 and below, because I know not everybody's budget is under 350, and it makes a big difference, so seeing what you can actually afford. So I hope this is very helpful. Reach out to me anytime if you got questions on these neighborhoods. And I look forward to talking to you guys soon. I'm going to go over these neighborhoods one more time by name. So we have North Chase, we have Quail Woods, Bayshore Estates, Carriage Hills, Brynwick, and Century Oaks. And those are all within New Hanover County. Okay, guys, reach out to me if you need anything. Please, if you like this, if it was helpful, go and give me the thumbs up. If you could subscribe, it helps us out a lot. We appreciate all the support, and we'll talk to you guys real soon. Again, this is Jake Wyer, Blue Coast Realty.